the police.
And arrest them, people.
You think I'm trolling?
You don't like me, family? You probably don't like me.
Why?
Because I'm a gypsy.
I'm a traveller.
People don't understand us.
These are our guns here, we got a shooting.
They don't want us living near them.
We always get people to look at us.
That's not fair.
It's a traveller thing.
We're proud of who we are.
Yeah, they got one.
There's too many of them.
They make it hard for us to keep our traditions.
Relax!
We're not going anywhere.
You're not getting this. And my daddy's like, you're not getting this.
Don't judge me. People call you Pikey. Was it me, Mum? Don't hate me.
So punch me up and knead me in the face.
I'm a gypsy kid.
This time.
Woohoo!
Traveller kids facing personal battles.
I had to leave that school because I got strangled.
I hate reading.
I've been told by the council that we've got to move. So what is it?
I love one good spin.
Can their tough gypsy spirit win the day?
I am asking for equality.
What? I'm not a very good reader.
What do you mean, darling?
Ten-year-old Irish traveller Scarlett has lived on this land her whole life.
Me and my family live on the site in the trailer. Everyone on the site is kind of related, like one big family.
Scarlett's home is on an official council site, tucked away behind a retail park in Hertfordshire.
Everyone on it is like nice and like, it's like a good site.
But Scarlett's community, who have lived here for almost 40 years, are living in fear of eviction.
We've been told by the council that we've got to move, but none of us wants to move. I don't like the plan.
The council has proposals for a vast housing and retail development, which they want to build on top of the travellers' site.
Go on, you go. We don't want to move because we've been here all our life, but all our grannies and everything has been here. Then build other houses and flats here for other people to live in. It's not right, is it?
If the council's plans are approved, 15 traveller families will be forced to relocate.
Like this, Scott, look, with the newspapers, Gypsy Site Road delays housing master plan. Basically, they're putting across that because of us, they can't get on with what they need to do.
But everything they put about us is always bad, isn't it?
They think that we're a nuisance, which we ain't. We don't cause no trouble to nobody. They're not thinking that this site has been here for 40-odd years. People have settled here now and have made a home of it, and it's what they call home.
Do you have to move to different school?
So there is a possibility that you might have to move doctors, schools, because you'd be out of the borough.
It feels like there's one rule for gorgeous and then there's another rule for travellers.
I think there'd be a lot made for, like, settled people. They were living in houses and they had to be moved, there'd be a lot of uproar.
Some people think travellers cause problems, but not everyone's the same. This traveller site is all quiet. The site's very friendly. If people got to know us, they would like us. It'd be good for everyone because they stay here.
Going. Whilst you're there, Ben, why not feed it through?
Yeah, feed it through the bottom as well. Yeah.
In Nottinghamshire, 13-year-old Ben is no stranger to prejudice. So learning trade skills from his dad is about more than maintaining his family's site.
Push that down, do you hear that click?
Yeah.
And then start to tie it up.
All right. I've been through some tough times and it makes it really hard for you to trust people. I think with me learning how to do these jobs, I don't have to rely on someone else to do it in the future. I can trust myself to do it.
Not that side, the other side.
That one?
Yeah.
Done.
Well done, Ben.
Ben's family are proud of their sight. But like many travellers, find that outsiders make assumptions about their way of life.
People think that travellers don't behave properly and are criminals. We want to live peacefully with any other community.
But for many traveller and gypsy kids, that's easier said than done. And over the years, Ben has had a hard time at school.
I've been to 10 schools. I'm only 13 years old. I had to leave that one because I got strangled for being a gypsy by some kid. I had to leave that one because some kid was bullying me and my sister and tried to make my sister eat grass and said, this is what dirty gypos eat.
Ben has recently started at school number 11. And so far, things seem to have taken a turn for the better.
Now I'm at this new school, everyone understands that I'm a gypsy.
Are we ready?
I'm getting more respect and more of an understanding of who I am.
I used to go to that school.
I've got some good friends there and everyone knows that I am a gypsy, but no one's really bothered. They just think he's a nice lad, so what's the point of me giving him problems?
I think I've got art today.
What is your favourite thing at school anyway?
Art.
Is it?
Yeah.
That and the dinner bell.
It's recorded. Today I'm feeling very excited. I'm having a party for Halloween with my brother and sister.
Hey!
It's a big night for Ben. On the guest list are traveller and settled friends from the local community and a new friend from school.
This is important for Ben because he's now got a pal from school coming. Now he started at this new school, he's got the opportunity to mix and make friends without feeling fear of being discriminated against.
And this special occasion calls for a distinguished style. A new friend Soren has arrived in full fancy dress.
What are you come as? Zombie jester.
Yeah, actually. Yeah.
It's nice for him to be able to have a pal from school that's not a traveller. It's very important.
Got any chocolate on my mouth?
Yeah.
It's really good that my friend Soren could come.
I wouldn't have been able to do this at my old school because I didn't really have any friends. I feel amazing.
But inspired by what he's been through, Ben is now driven to help other gypsy kids. And he's got big plans.
Well, things are going well with me at the moment, but it makes me feel like I want to do my part and make sure that we don't have to face racism every day and we can just live like anyone else.
I hate it. I hate school.
You got to learn how to read and write and do your maths or you won't be able to get a job.
You will, Annalise.
I love reading, but not the school books, what they've got. The only thing is about the school books, they're not very interesting.
Jim, if you can't read and write, how are you supposed to get a job?
Yeah.
I love them so much. Lego's in the pram, so let me do my work.
8-year-old Rhiann is a Romani traveller who has lived in South Wales all her life.
You ready?
I hate reading.
4 months ago, Rhiann was taken out of school after she was bullied by other travellers.
We
drink.
Drink.
She's really finding English really hard. But she's behind for his age.
Drink. A lot of water.
Good girl. I pulled her out of school, but I'm not going to leave my gal in there with three traveller boys elbowing her, trying to trip her over when she's walking the corridor. What did I say?
Egg.
No, sound it out.
Rhiann's mum believes she was bullied for having unconventional ambitions for a traveller girl.
It's school like that, and I'm older. I wish that I can be a dance teacher and an actor.
I got happy face, sad face, and attitude.
That's a good one, yeah. Nearly every traveller girl, they're just cleaning up. When they get to a certain age, they're looking for a boyfriend, then they're wanting to get married. I don't want that kind of life. For my daughter, I want her to enjoy life and earn his own money. Yeah. Show me your pouch.
Rhiann takes private drama lessons, and Mum is now on a mission to find her an agent.
Show me the smile, what you do. I'm so excited for her just to show her talent, and hopefully someone will recognise that talent and make her successful. Hello?
Hello, Anne. My name's Bonnie. I'm calling from one of the leading children's agencies, and I'd really, really like to meet Rhiann. So I'm going to send you over a script, and then when I meet her, I'm going to go through a scene with her, and then we'll sort of take it from there.
Oh, thank you very much. Thank you. Bye. Rhiann?
Yeah?
I got some good news.
What?
They're going to see you Saturday, and if you do good, and one thing or another, they're going to take you on.
Yay!
She's going to send me a script over.
I just want to be on Coronation Street.
You want to be on Coronation Street?
Come on.
What about the script? How do you feel about that?
I'm not sure about that. No, I don't know what it's going to be like. I think I'm going to have a little one, a big one, I don't know.
So me and you together will learn the script together. So no stressing, nothing. It's exciting, isn't it? Yeah?
There's a little bit of pressure for her, but
you never know, she might be a Hollywood actress.
And then she'll make it one day.
90% of Gypsy and Traveller children have reported being bullied. And like Rhiann, 13-year-old Ben has faced his own battles at school. He's much happier since moving to school number 11.
I'm really grateful at the moment that I found the new school. That I'm going to stay at until year 11 and do my GCSEs.
But what he's been through is shaping his thoughts for the future.
I feel that if I can get a good career out of helping people with problems that they face, then I'm doing my part to help travellers not to face racism. And that's what I want to do.
And he's already started by emailing a traveller organisation to highlight something of concern.
It's a booklet by an MP. It's an antisocial booklet. And in there it covers the usual stuff, graffiti, loitering, noisy neighbours, and then a whole page on travellers. Why are travellers inside an antisocial behaviour booklet? Then people are going to think I'm antisocial. But I'm not, I'm a good guy. It's just things like this that'll always keep stopping me in my life, because it's prejudices like this that I have to face. Whenever I see something like this, then it's my duty to report it.
Ben will have to wait to see if the charity he's written to can help him take a stand. In Hertfordshire, the council's plans for a new retail and housing development mean 8-year-old Scarlett's traveller community is facing its own waiting game.
Scarlett?
Yeah?
Tom's coming up.
Right.
They could soon be forced to move from the land they've lived on for over 40 years.
Obviously, we've been living here for a lot of years. You can see how long ago that was.
Yeah. Is that gone and rose?
It's been from, black and white cameras to nail cameras.
That's my dad. That's Granny and that's Grandpa.
Yeah. I'd like to stay here for, a lot more years until I get, older. And if I had children, I'd like to bring them up here
and make more memories and stuff of being here.
The council's plans have not yet been greenlit, but they've already marked out land where the travellers would be moved to. And this morning, Scarlett and her friends are setting out to find it.
They want us to move into the middle of nowhere, like in a load of trees.
I think the site's there.
I think the site's there.
Scarlett's been given directions, but the site isn't proving easy to reach.
Everything's froze!
It's like a big forest. It's like where animals would live. Now you've got to the end of the road and you're like all shops and everything. It only takes us like 5 minutes to get to school.
After an hour of searching, Scarlett and her friends have finally found the land they were looking for.
What do you think? It's like rubbish.
Well, I think if we had to go to school, like in the morning, it'd be hard to get out of the woods.
You wouldn't get there in time, would you?
Oh, shit.
If I'd stay here, I couldn't cope.
People probably think just because, like, we've got a trailer, we can hook on the move.
For most of the families on Scarlett's site, a move would mean completely dismantling their homes.
It makes you upset that we've got to move. It's still our home at the end of the day.
Can't wait to get home.
In Surrey, another English traveller has a different sort of fight on their hands. Boxing is a sport that has a long tradition in traveller culture. But one thing has always been set in stone. Fighting is not for girls. 16-year-old Jessie is tearing up the rule book.
I don't know why I wouldn't do boxing. I just always loved it.
Jessie is an accomplished fighter and can hold her own against the boys she trains with.
The boys don't really hold back on me, so I don't hold back on them. I was sparring in the gym the other day and plucked my eye up. Didn't really hurt. Just black
eye. She trains every night. Goes running there. Yeah, she's dedicated to it. She don't really stop.
It's not just an hobby. What you put in, that's what you get out.
But while Jessie is breaking the mould, she's also been brought up with traditional Gypsy values.
She has to make time for it and all got clean and doing the house.
Remember when my dad used to say, what you're going to be when you're older? You say boxer. And he'll laugh.
Jessie had to fight just to be allowed to pull on a pair of boxing gloves.
Travelling girls has brought up to cook and clean, look after the home. Boxing and that, it's a hard sport. And I was just worried about it, you know.
When my dad says no, that means no. I just didn't pay no for an answer.
On the buzzer, let's just start working on the feet.
Okay, then. Wait a minute. When I'm at the gym, I'm the only girl up there.
Same again, yeah? Keep tight, don't box
off. Definitely doing me. I reckon she'd do us at the same time.
Yeah. When she first started, I thought she'd jack it in, find out the training, it was a bit too hard for her. She proved us all wrong.
Tomorrow, Jessie has her biggest fight yet.
Jab, jab, move, cross. Yeah. Good. That's it, good.
She's representing the south of England in a contest against the best female fighters from the north.
Good shot. Well done. Yeah, you're sharp as anything.
I just want to win. The worst thing that can happen is I lose.
The fight is a big opportunity for Jessie.
Big day tomorrow. All the top coaches there looking for the best girl to come through.
And having been dead against his daughter fighting, she's now being cheered on by her number one fan.
When I watch her, it's still nerve-wracking, but she holds her own.
That's lovely work. She won't deal with that speed.
She proved that she got a talent and she loves doing it.
Now I'll just support her, you know. And time. Well done, Jessie.
Finish now.
Yeah, that's Christy.
Eight-year-old Rhiann was recently pulled out of school She was being bullied by other travellers for her dream to be a performer.
Dance. I love dancing. That's my best thing ever. I feel really excited, fun, happy and stuff.
So what do you think about your outfit then?
I love it. It's so sparkly, so nice. It's so pinky. My favourite colour is Scarlett and the Wiggles. I like it.
Rhiann is an only child. And Mum and Dad are already getting her used to the showbiz lifestyle.
I got a mum that supports me right now, and I got a dad that supports me. 1, 2, 3. If I say, oh, I want that, he goes and get it for me.
That's belonged to her. And he'd done 7 miles in 3 years.
When I was young, parents didn't do nothing for the girls, but I think back them years ago, the travellers didn't realise what's out there. My brothers, they had the best time, but the girls didn't do nothing, really. I want to see my daughter successful in life.
Rhiann's squad, so everybody knows.
The way I look at it is if she can dance, if she can sing and she can act, that means she'll get a good future. Right, listen, your first word is, I'm not wearing it. OK, so say it.
I'm not wearing it.
In 2 days, Rhiann has an audition with an acting agency in London.
Well, yours isn't silly. Let me wear that one.
Yours ain't silly. Let me wear that one.
But since leaving school, she's fallen behind with her reading, and that could be a problem.
At the moment, I got to help her to learn the scripts. It's all by memory for Rhiann. She's never really learnt to be really confident of reading.
Well, why will I wear something else?
It's his choice.
This is a chance for Rhiann to realise her acting dreams. And although reading is a struggle, she's not giving up.
I'm not sucking on to the dummy, and I'm definitely not going in.
She's determined to do it. Stayed up one night till 10 o'clock, constantly going on the script. Do you want to start again?
But I'm not wearing it.
You have to wear it.
Every spare moment is taken up with rehearsals. In the evening, she's getting extra help from Dad.
Well, yours ain't silly. Let me wear your one.
No, this is my one and it doesn't fit you anyway.
I hate fancy dress parties!
Fabulous.
And she's having one-on-one sessions with her drama teacher.
If you use your loudest voice and then you need to get bigger and bigger...
Well, I'm not wearing a fib and I'm not sucking on a dummy and I'm definitely not going in the large pram! I've done it all without even help!
That was brilliant. We're done. Well done. Good day.
Rhiann has done all she can. She just needs to remember everything she's learned.
I'm so happy that I've done that.
I'm very, very proud of you.
When I grow up, I want to be a boxer.
I think travellers are so good at boxing because, like, they put their, like, heart into it.
Because it's just like what a traveller man or a traveller boy would do, really.
It runs in your blood, really, for a traveller.
Yeah, it's in traveller's blood.
The girls shouldn't fight because they're not men.
Boxing.
Yeah, I'm going boxing too.
Sixteen-year-old Jessie is breaking the gypsy mould. Today, she's competing in an all-girl boxing gala.
Most traveling girls about 16, 17 gets married and that. I just want to do boxing.
It's the first time she would be fighting at national level.
I'm going to represent South England and fighting against the North.
Jessie's whole family has turned out in support.
We all come out as a family together. I personally think that she's going to win.
The travellers are strong-minded in anything. Once I put them onto it, it's dedication, isn't it?
for Jessie's dad, who was once so against the idea of her boxing. This is a big moment.
She got nervous, but I falls to pieces when she's fighting. Gets frightened and then gets in the ring, you know.
Just before fight, I just clear my head and just focus. Just try and keep calm.
Jessie grew up being told she would never box. Now, she's on the national stage.
When you go in the ring, you've got to believe yourself that you can win.
As well as Jessie's family, she's being watched by leading coaches from the world of British boxing.
The most important thing in boxing is to not get angry, not lose temper. Stay relaxed. When you're in the ring, everyone's shouting. Don't take notice anymore.
Winning today will open doors for Jessie. But this time, victory eludes her.
I feel sad that I lost. Put so much work into just one fight.
She's done good enough to win, you know, in my opinion, so it's just boxing, isn't it?
Back home, Jessie is undeterred by her defeat.
Losing makes you want to be better and stronger. It makes you fight harder and makes you train harder as well.
She'll still have to fit training around the job she has to do at home. But these days, her dad is fully behind all her boxing ambitions.
Some girls get married at Jessie's age, have children, and like messes their life up, really. I'd rather live a bit and see life and see the world, you know?
I'd love to go in the Olympics. I'm just going to give it the best shot and just train as hard as I can. I love boxing, I love training. I love winning.
In Nottinghamshire, Ben wants to fight the prejudice faced by gypsies and travellers. He's been in touch with the traveller organisation to highlight discrimination in a political booklet. His email has had an unexpected result.
I've been invited to speak at a conference by the traveller movement that helps gypsies and travellers. They've asked me to talk about being bullied.
Moving between so many schools has had an impact on Ben's education, and he can struggle with reading and writing. The conference audience will include politicians and community leaders, so it's important the speech goes well.
Come on then, sweetheart. Just be nice and calm and you'll be fine.
To be a gypsy is not defined by how you are, how you live.
Just relax. Relax, OK?
Slow down,
all right? As much time as you take is fine.
Hate crime and discrimination affects all sorts of people, not just our community. It is both degrading and humiliating. I've never really spoken in front of a big group of people before, but I just hope everything goes all right. I am proud of being from my gypsy blood.
Fantastic. The best speeches come from the heart, and I can tell straight away that comes from your heart.
That's beautiful. Well done, Ben. Well done.
With only a week until the conference, Ben's concerned about his performance, so he's turning to brother Dan for advice.
I'm feeling a bit nervous about it, you know, because my reading skills are a bit iffy at the moment. You know, if I mumble on a word, Dan, that people are gonna think, oh, he doesn't know what he's talking about, this is all.
When you're talking, nobody's gonna judge you for it. Nobody's there to say, oh, that's wrong, or that's wrong. People are just gonna say it's brilliant. Why? Because you're fantastic.
Just relax.
Today, Rhiann has to overcome her own issues with reading. She's come to London hoping to impress a leading acting agency.
A bit nervous.
What are you nervous about?
I'm nervous about getting it wrong, like getting the words wrong.
Just be happy and don't stress, OK? No, it's only going to be that, right? OK?
Yeah.
Very few travellers have ever made it in show business.
You can take your script in with you.
And if Rhiann does a good job with the script today, she could become the first traveller this agency has ever represented.
Rhiann? Rhiann? Hi, darling, how are you doing? Come through with me.
It will really mean the world that if she gets taken on by this agency, because I know she'd be looked after properly. All I want is the best for my girl.
Well, listen, I sent you a little script, didn't I? It wasn't very difficult. It was just a really short little script. So should we give it a go when you're ready?
I'm not wearing it.
You have to wear it.
No, I do.
Look, if you want to go to the party, then you do.
Where am I?
Could you hold the script for me? If you want to, you can keep your finger under the words.
Wait. I'm not wearing it.
You have to wear it.
Well, I'm not a very good reader.
What do you mean, darling?
Well, I... See, this is the part when I get all mixed up.
Don't you panic. You do best you can.
Well, I am not wearing the bib. I'm not sucking the dummy. And I'm definitely...
not getting in that large pram.
Not getting in that large pram.
Well, thank you. Thank you for coming in. It's been really lovely to meet you. But my biggest bit of advice to you, if you want to be an actress, is read lots and lots and lots.
Yeah.
Yeah? But thank you for coming. Let's go and get Mummy. Come with me.
Well done. I know that you've got to be like a good reader to have these scripts to read. But she is coming on reading now. Let's just keep it going now. You know, just keep climbing it. And like whatever I need to do, I'm gonna do. I think she's amazing for a little traveller girl. I really do. Yeah.
I've got a bit of a script.
Yeah.
Because I was really...
nervous.
Yeah.
Me and your dad's really proud of you. You don't get traveller girls doing what you're doing.
Yeah, I'm proud. The worst thing about being a traveller is when a lot of people don't like you and they just make fun of you and they start bullying you.
Most soldiers don't like travellers for some reason. They think that they're bad people.
They think that we're dirty, we stink, they think that we steal.
It makes me want to tell them that they're wrong and tell them that you shouldn't be mean to them.
Yeah, you can't just look at someone and then judge them.
Since visiting the plot of land her family might be forced to move to, Scarlett and her friends have decided to take action.
What we're trying to do is try and tell the council we don't want to move.
They want to turn local opinion against the council's plans for the new housing development.
DW, it's time to show that we're not going to move. We want to stay. There's my paint here, look. Probably you keep doing dodgy teas. Cattle litter. Oh, let me write a movie, yeah? There you go.
The children's efforts have already drawn some attention from great Uncle Albert, who has lived here for almost 40 years.
It's a good idea, I reckon. People can see it, can't they, from the roads as they go by.
Albert's like one of the oldest ones on the site. We call him Muchie. Uncle Muchie's like a nice man.
Well, we don't want to move, that's for sure, isn't it?
You know? Yeah.
I want to stay here.
It's not fair, because other people can live on it, but we can't.
That's right.
I don't know, if they build all the houses and shops here, they make more money out of it. We've been born here, we've been here, like,
load of years, and how would you feel moving?
We're terrible, really.
I think we've got to make more and more, and, like, keep on to them and on to them. About it.
Then I make a damn well after stay.
Then that's to do something about it, don't they?
Yeah.
We don't want to move and train them. Good days.
Oh, but where are we putting this one?
If people knew what he was like, they'd probably think to themselves, like, we'll try and help him a bit more. Don't cause no trouble.
The signs are already catching the eye of the passers-by.
People are honking and, like they maybe want us to stay.
But Scarlett isn't convinced that the travellers' families can count on local support.
We always get people that look at us. I think you're just doing that, because they want us to move and we don't want to move.
Because you've seen all the signs and we don't want to stay here. And he probably wants a new house here.
The traveller's fate will be decided within the next few months.
Another one just been.
Yeah, come!
If the council's plans go through, the families who have called this site home for generations will have no option but to move.
I don't think it's kind of easy, like try and get us off to so. No, I'm just gonna go, yeah, fine, we'll go. We're not gonna go without a fight.
We don't wanna move! We don't wanna move!
It's not paused, is it? I don't know the words.
It's the day of Ben's speech, and he's getting ready for the drive to London.
Yes. Put the bag in the car, and then off we go.
Brilliant.
I might read through my speech again just to get more practice in.
Great.
Ben's speaking at a conference that will see politicians, campaigners and community leaders coming together to discuss the interests of gypsies and travellers.
I feel that I've got an opportunity now to get my voice heard and do my part to stop hate crime and racism with travellers and gypsies. We just want to be living in harmony with other communities.
The public's perception, the ethnicity traveller, the ethnicity gypsy, is something to be afraid of, something to be worried about, a problem.
There's more people here than I expected, because I only expected a small group of people, but it turns out there's loads.
You'll be fine, honestly.
Well, you've got an amazing speech. Do you know what? I reckon you're going to blow them all away.
Alongside Ben on the lineup, our race equality expert, Lord Herman Ousley, and MP Kate Green.
Abuse of gypsy Roman traveller people is not new.
It's a big thing that I've been asked to do, but it's important for me to talk about what's made me feel so pushed aside all these years. I'm able to take all that negative and turn it into a positive.
I'm going to come to Ben now.
Ben Bennett, who is a campaigner.
Ben, welcome.
Thank you. My name is Ben Bennett. In just my 13 years of life, I have dealt with finding a school who accepts gypsies, being bullied, watched as my parents' car was set on fire. All this because I am a gypsy. I'm very proud to be a Romany gypsy, and I will always be, no matter what people say or do. I know that I will have to work harder than the non-gypsies, but I will succeed. I'm not asking for sympathy. I am asking for equality. Don't hate people because they are different. Love the differences, because being different is the best thing about being a person. Thank you. It's a long way for gypsies and travellers to go to actually live in peace with other communities. And I want people to understand that travellers are just like anyone else. There's good and bad in our community, and there's good and bad in your community as well.
It was amazing, absolutely amazing. Oh, God, I love you so much.
I've done that myself.
So you started something now, and
this is something I want to keep doing.
Feel proud of yourself?
Yeah, I do. I couldn't be prouder of myself. Sounds a bit biased, that does, but
what did you think when everyone stood up at the end clapping?
I was thinking, hey, Kushti.
Come on, get up quick, we've got to go.
Rhiann's recent acting audition has given her and her mum a lot of food for thought.
When she went for the audition, everything was by memory, but at the end of the day, she needs to read.
All I know is easy words, I don't know long words. But I'm never going to do anything if I just think myself I can't do it. So all I have to do is try and try.
For Rhiann to fulfil her acting dreams, they've come up with a master plan.
Take it off now, come on. Rhiann's been back to school for 2 months. I was dreading to do it. I thought I just don't want the bullying to start. But I took the crunch, and to be honest with you, so far I can wish for a better school.
Bye.
Bye, baby. Love you. Bye, Rhiann.
Then when I first went to school, I was a bit stressed out and a bit nervous and stuff. But my teacher, they helped me at my reading. All you have to do is put your hand up, because sometimes I can't read and write.
To help with her progress, Rhiann is having extra lessons outside of her normal classes.
These are the words that are in the book.
Tricky.
That are tricky, yes. So the first one is seven. Okay. When Rhiann first started, she was reading at an age of around 4 years, 5 months. Can you remember what that tricky word was? Huh.
People.
People. Okay, so we've got...
Some people are scared of spiders.
Good girl.
Yes.
For Rhiann to be at the age of the other children in her year, she's going to need support for this and probably the following year. She's picking it up really, really quickly. We're doing sounds and learning, obviously, keywords every day, and she is remembering them. I'm really, really pleased with how well she's doing. Good girl, do you think you deserve a sticker?
Yeah.
I think you deserve 2 stickers.
If she can keep up the good work, Rhiann could soon become competition for other girls at auditions.
I'm here. When I get older, I want to be famous. And everybody knows that every time that I walk out that door, everybody just notices me. Bye, miss.
I just wanted to be able to pick a script up, read it no problem, and just show everybody this is what Rhiann's made of.
Right, have you brought your homework?
I wanted to have an amazing future that I've never had.
Only one play you can have here.
If ever she could walk that red carpet, if ever she can do that, I would be so proud. Yeah.
I'm losing my patience by now on. If you don't bring your homework in, that would be no play for a week.
I think myself, you're a very good actor, very good.
Next time. Cousins William and Devon go head-to-head in a traditional traveller horse drive.
I'm going to find out today who's fastest.
Relax! But not too strong.
Daddy's girl, Lindiana, gets her chance to shine.
Mama, relax! Kentucky, keep on shining.
Oh, I'm very proud of him.
OK, next question.
And 9-year-old Paddy...
Easy, Paddy!
..tries to convince his brother he's ready to leave school.
Look, Paddy, look!
What's T4s?
T4s is...
What is it?
And new Gypsy Kids, Our Secret World continues Thursday at 10 on Channel 5.